Number one, if you have a creatinine clearance of more than 30, you better use thiazide diuretics than the hydrochlorothiazide. Indapamide and glutathione are better than hydrochlorothiazide. If you have a creatinine clearance of less than 30, you might have a lot of edema, you use a loop diuretic. You can use furosemide, torsemide, and metolazole. This is for the diuretics. Number two, calcium channel blocker and beta blocker. You can use, there's a two type. One is dihydropyridine, deltia is in pyrimidine. They predominantly dilate afferent RDO. They have an increased GFR, but also the intracranial pressure. They also have a reduced in proteinuria as well. Non-dihydropyridine, amlodipine, do not have this effect. So if you look at the non-dihydropyridine CCV, pyrimidine and deltiazine may confer greater reduction of proteinuria than the dihydropyridine CCV, amlodipine, fludipine. We don't like amlodipine because what they say is amlodipine abolishes the renal autoangulation. So renal autoregulation destroy. Usually amlodipine is it doesn't have an effect on the albuminuria. And non-dihydropyridine, pyrimidine and deltiazine, they partially abolish, they reduce the albuminuria, they reduce the expansion of the mesangial volume, they reduce the scarring of the glomerulus. So if you use the CCB, deltiazine and pyrimidine is better than amlodipine in case of DKD. And you use this, you can look at that data as well. Beta blocker, you can use it mainly in the case of the IHG, mainly in the high cardiovascular risk. And we do recommend vasodilating beta blocker, just like metoprolol and carvedilol. Alpha blocker, you can also use as well. So this is the EADA ESC guideline for treatment of hypertension DM. If you have a blood pressure of less than 160 by 100, you can start with one agent. But you have to look at the albuminuria. If you have an albuminuria, you use ACM or ARB. If you don't have an albuminuria, you can use anything you like, ACM, ARB, or calcium channel, or diuretic, whatever it is. If you have an initial blood pressure more than 160 over 100, you start with two. You have an albuminuria, you use ACM, ARB, and CCB, or diuretics. And you have no albuminuria, you can use anything you like, but you have to combine. So more than 160-100, you start with two. Less than 160-100, you start with one. Albuminuria present, you use ACI and ARB. So these are the same thing. If you cannot use it, control the blood pressure, you better combine ACD. So this is another management. So you look at this one, this is my command. It's not in the guideline. You can use ACI and ARB first. If you want to combine, AC is better. If you want to combine ACI, CCB, diuretic, ACD, or later on, if you have a resistant hepatic, you can combine ABCD. Or you can combine ACBD, aldosterone, alpha blocker. Or you can combine ABCD, aldosterone, alpha blocker, beta blocker, methionine dopa. Later on, renal innervation. So some hypertension in diabetes, you need this kind of combination a lot, but we're not doing that too much on renal denervation. So they don't recommend combination of ACI and ARB. How about combination of RAS and aldosterone antagonist or dry renal inhibitor, just like aliskirin? You can have many data, but you have to be very careful about hyperkalemia and the gynecomastia if you combine ACI and aldosterone in that cases. For the lipid, we recommend using statin or statin plus acetamide combination to reduce the risk of major atherosclerotic event in patients with diabetes and CKD. So we do recommend. And then even though a patient received a kidney transplant, we do recommend. But we recommend not initiating statin therapy in patients with diabetes who are treated by dialysis. If you have a patient with a dialysis, don't stir it, because in dialysis patient, not stirring, there's no significant CV reduction in 4D study and Aurora study. They have 30. If you start stirring in patient with diabetes patient, CKD with dialysis, there's no cardiovascular reduction treatment. So therefore, according to that data, we don't usually start studying. But if you are even using orally receive the studying, you please continue patient when the dialysis. So these are the recommendation for the guideline. So there are a lot of data and a lot of trial for studying as well. So I just want to highlight this one. Use studying alone or studying plus azetamide in adult more than 50 years with CKD 3 to 5 non-dialysis. Use studying alone in adult more than 50 years in CKD 1 to as well. If you are a patient less than 50, use studying if you have no CKD, no respectable MI, or no respectable TM on stroke. So these are the data. Only thing I just want to mention is what statin you have to use. You look at this one, etoposide, you don't need to reduce a dose. You can give up to 80 milligrams under CKD stage 5. In kidney transplant patient, you have to reduce a little bit. If you use fluvastatin, you don't need to reduce your dose as well. So you can use all the way to stage 1 to 5, statin, etoba, and fluva, because they are metabolized in bile and the liver. If you use the rosuvastatin, it is excreted by the kidney, you have to reduce. So mainly where you're using etoba and rosuva. So in etoba is good for the renal, and then rosuva is good for the liver. Cardiovascular risk is very much important. You have to assess the cardiovascular risk. This is the only thing I would like to emphasize. So diet, I don't want to go detail. For the low protein diet, low salt, low fat, low phosphate diet, and the protein restriction, already mentioned, less than 0.8 fat intake, and the energy intake should be 30 to 35 kilocalorie per kilogram a day. So intake should be less than 1.5 to 2.3. So carbohydrate intake, they don't clearly mention what portion of carbohydrate has to take. The whole grain, increase whole grain, fiber, fruit, and vegetable, reduce the sugar. That is only thing they recommended for the diet and the kidney. So these are some existing evidence and gap in the knowledge in the diabetes management in CKD. So I don't want to go detail as well. So these are so another one is you need to educate the patient, healthy lifestyle, smoking, weight reduction, regular follow-up your doctor, I'll refer to nephrologist, blood sugar control, glass of water, 8 glasses of water, essential to hydrate well, what goes in must go out, more than 2 liter urine per day, essential to prevent kidney stone formation, hemoglobin. So these are the recommendations for complete management of type 2 in renal impairment. So you need to recommend smoking cessation, diet, weight, exercise, blood pressure, glucose. We repeat again. So if you have a problem with kidney, these are all the complications. I don't want to touch today because Professor Kendrani has already mentioned everything as well. Fluid overload, acid-base balance, bone diseases, hypertension, anemia, you have to think everything. So I just want to show one pentosan filing. It's a competitive non-selected phosphodiesterase inhibitor. It inhibits synthesis TNF-alpha interleukin-1, interleukin-6. The role of inflammatory marker in pathogenesis of diabetic nephropathy. Study showed that administration of pentosan filing 800 mg a day is safe, effective, for reducing proteinuria in patients with proteinuric primary glomerular disease as well. The beneficial effect in close relation with reduction of urine MCR excretion. Pentosan filing, renal protection in diabetic nephropathy. This is a pre-dietian study. You can log in the internet and you can see that study as well. Clinical trials are going on, result awaited. Another way, we are using a lot of alpha keto log, just like keto straight or something like that. This is mainly go with the low protein diet. So this is my last slide. Last slide is lower pressure, again, 130-80, block IS system, improve glycemia, reduce the lipid, anemia, 11 to 12, endothelial protection, aspirin, smoking cessation, go for education, malnutrition and CKD, vaccination also important. You need annual influenza vaccine. You need a pneumococcal patient, one GEGFI less than 30. You need a hepatitis B immunization, one GFI less than 30. Uric acid, vitamin D, calcium phosphate, depression as well. So this is Professor moving on, mentioned about multidisciplinary approaches. We need this kind of thing, we need. And this is our dream. So, and one day, we might have a DKD clinic, and we have a nephrologist sitting here, cardiologist, automatic endocrinologist physician, vascular surgeon, nutritionist, drink M2. Thank you so much. Thank you.
CFAM, caring for well-being.